technique. And seven gospel and country performers frequently garner support from the same base, regardless of the direction it is taken. However, gospel music remains rooted in evangelical Protestantism. In the development of early gospel music, the role of the Hartford Music Company and its roster of important songwriters, namely E.M. Barnett and Albert E. Brumley, cannot be underestimated. Barnett penned such timeless songs as "Everybody Will Be Happy Over There" and "Victory in Jesus," while Brumley, Barnett's protege, became the most recognized in Southern gospel in such music as "I'll Fly Away," "Turn Your Radio On," "I'll Meet You in the Morning," and "Jesus Hold My Hand," appear as well as regarded in traditional gospel circles today. They were before sound recordings replaced singing convention songbooks. The primary medium in which early gospel music was mass marketed, early black gospel recordings of Barnett and Romney songs show their widespread appeal. Roberta Martin influenced black gospel music in much the same way that Barnett and Romney did, popularized gospel music among a predominantly white constituency. The Helena Phillip County native made her mark in Chicago. I'm talking about Roberta Martin, where so many successful black gospel careers were launched. Regarded as a rock and roll pioneer, Sister Rosetta Thorpe, I said Sister Rosetta Thorpe, of Cotton Plant, Arkansas, indelibly transformed gospel music, rising to prominence with "Rock Me" as a version of Thomas Dorsey's "Hide Me in Thy Bosom," as part of John Hammond's Front Spirituals of Swing concert in 1938. Thorpe influenced a wide range of secular and gospel musicians, all the while stirring the controversy over her decision to straddle the line between gospel, blues, and jazz. Songs by Twyla Parks, who took music by storm in the 1990s, have become an integral part of Sunday morning worship across the country. An all-female contemporary Christian gospel group called The Point of Grace, which was founded by four Washington Baptist College students in 1991, all went on to sell millions of records and score multiple number one hits. Gospels of Smokey Norfolk resonate from urban megachurches to small town storefront congregations. Joanne Cash, Sister Country Western legend Johnny Cash, performs even today many of the songs of the black gospel genre. Now I gotta go to a sequel. But today,